Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at alkane reactions. Now we're going to say alkanes are referred to as paraffins. Okay, which is derived from Latin meaning little affinity. Here, when they say little affinity, that means that they're not very reactive. That's because alkanes are just hydrocarbons. Alkanes have no pi bonds, no electronegative elements anywhere, so it's nonpolar. So its main intermolecular force is London dispersion, a nonpolar force. And when it comes to chemistry and reactions, reactions happen best when there is some polarity in the compound. Now, we're going to say that alkanes really only undergo two major types of reactions. One that we've seen from the very beginning of chemistry, combustion. So remember, in combustion, our alkane, our hydrocarbon, reacts with O2 to produce CO2 and water. So we could have methane gas reacting with O2 gas to produce H2O liquid plus CO2 gas. Here we just need to balance it. We have four hydrogens here, but only two here, so we throw a two. And then we'd have, two times one, that's two oxygens, plus another two here is four. So I throw a two here. So that one we're accustomed to seeing. Now the new one that's connected to organic chemistry, it's called radical catalyzed halogenation. So what in the world does that mean? So in radical catalyzed halogenation, we have an alkane, a simple alkane. So let's say we have that methane. And what we do with this methane is we use X2 over heat or light. And not just any type of light, UV light. And this UV light can be represented by symbol HV. So when you see HV, it just means UV light. And when I say X2, X equals Cl or Br. And what's happening here is that we're transforming our alkane into a new compound. And in this reaction, what happens is a hydrogen is replaced with a halogen. So one of these hydrogens, one of the four hydrogens, will get replaced with, let's say, Cl. And we get this new compound. This compound now is polar because it has chlorines involved. Chlorine is very electronegative. And the thing about this is that this reaction can continue forth even more. So we could bring in another mole of X2, some more heat, some more light, and that would replace another hydrogen. We could keep bringing in more X2, more Cl2, more heat, more light to replace another. And then do it one more time. So at the end, what we'll have is CCl4 as our compound. So you go from methane to methyl chloride to methylene chloride. Remember, I told you earlier that CH2 is called methylene. Methylene chloride to chloroform to finally carbon tetrachloride. So this reaction is just a way of replacing hydrogens with halogens. And you could either replace just one, or you just do monohalogenation, or you could just pump in a ton of Cl2 or Br2, a ton of heat, a ton of light, and replace all the hydrogens on the carbons with halogens. That's much harder to do, and usually this reaction only replaces one hydrogen with a halogen. But this would be the organic type of reaction that we're accustomed to seeing. Combustion is a basic type, more gen chem specific. This here is more organic specific. So remember, these are the two major reactions that any alkane can undergo.